This is a short tutorial on audio routing in DP that I usually do in my DP classes or my DP tutorials. First, let's look at our hardware setup. So let's go to the setup menu, configure audio system, and configure studio settings. Here we can set how many buses that should be in our project. And there are 32 stereo buses. You can change this number, but of course it depends on your hardware, your computer, how many buses it actually is capable of processing. 32 is a nice number. I usually don't change it. So let's just let it sit there. Let's go to setup, configure audio systems, and configure hardware driver. This is where we choose which of our hardware interfaces that we're going to use. Some might just have one. Here I have multiples. Right now my master device is set to my PCI 424 MOTU, and that is running two 1296s and 124i MOTU interface. We can change it to a MOTU 896HD or Apollo. Now, in this case, I might want to use multiple of these. So what I can do is hold down the command key and simply click on the MOTU 896HD, the PCI 424. My master device is set to the Apollo. Buffer size is set to max 1024. Now, as I have three devices selected here, I will change my host buffer multiplier to 3. Work priority is high, fine. So let's click OK. Some of the things that can be a little puzzling to people when they get into MOTU the first time, let's go back to the studio menu and go down and open our bundles window. Now bundles is a virtual patch bay inside DP. So let's just bring this out, make it big here. And you will see we have some tabs here. We have inputs, outputs, which is selected. We have buses, instrument, and MIDI devices. And if we look here, we have the Apollo, we have the MOTU 896, and then we have what is connected to the PCI 424. And you can see here there's the two 1296s, the first one and the second one start here, and the 24i is over here. So here's all our hardware inputs. One is selected here, and the one that's selected, we can see it's called 1296 ones analog AES12, and that is selected to the 1296 one analog AES1 and 2. This is going to be my master output, and I want my master output to come out of the Apollo, which is where my studio monitoring system is set up. So I'll simply double click, and the left and right, as it's a stereo, will move over here. You see the name changed here. Now we have in our project, there's no files in here, so we could start recording. We could add mono tracks, stereo tracks, MIDI tracks, surround tracks, and start recording. Or I'll just drag a piece of audio in here. And we hear sound. Now, what is maybe a little confusing, if we go to the mixing board, we don't see a master fader. Usually you would think on when you look at a console, there's always a master fader, there's always bus faders. They're not up here. When we set this up, as you can see down here, it says output 1-2. You could see it here. Output 1-2. We can see it in tracks. Output stream 1-2, which again is related to, let's go to our bundles window, is related to this name. Now we can change this name. So we can double click on it and just call it main out. Now we call it main out, let's close it. And you will see the name here has changed to main out. Here, main out. In our mixing board, it's called main out. If I want a master fader, let's just go to project and add a master fader track. And you will see that it is automatically called main out. So let's play some music. And we can control the overall volume come out of this. And the other thing that I can do with the master fader track is we can fold down so we can listen to the mix in mono. Stereo, it's a stereo bus, so that's not available. I can just go to non. In DP, you can have up to 20 insert points and you're gonna have up to 20 cents. Now let's look at how would you add more cents if you need more cents. Up here in the upper right corner of the mixer window, we have the mini menu. And if you click on that, we can go down here to set number of cents. And we'll change this to 6 right now. And you'll see right now we have 6 cents. Now, if we want to bus this, we want to add a reverb to this track. We will go to project, add a track. We will add aux track. We can add multiple aux tracks. So we can type in the number, how many we want. So right now I want 2. So I want a long reverb and just an ambience reverb. So let's insert the reverb. Now you'll see it doesn't populate the window. The reason why it doesn't populate the window is because I haven't set up a bus coming into the reverb. So we'll just go down here where it says audio input. And we can select bus 1. That's one way to do it. Another way I could do this is go to the Studios menu and call up our bundles window again. And now we'll click on buses. You'll see we have bus number 1 through 64. As if you remember, when we started the session, I said I had 32 stereo buses. That's why we see 1 through 64 right here. Now I want to add 2. As if we go back and look here, I want to have an ambience and I want to have a longer reverb. So I want to add multiple and I want to add 2 mono buses. Say OK. And automatically it's selected bus 1 and bus 2. So if we go back here now and click, you'll see bus 1 and bus 2 has now become active in my selector. And as you remember from before, I can just double click on it here and call it verb. And the other one we'll call amp for ambience. So if we go back here now, this will be our verb and this will be our ambience. So if we click on this now and open up, we can see the interface. So we will add this over here and just select the ambience. Now we will route it from the audio channel, of course. The first one will go to the verb. Probably take them down a little bit. Second one we'll send to the ambience. So that's how we do the routing. What can be even more a little bit puzzling is if we go to project and look at add track again and say we still have master fader track, okay? So let's add 2 more master fader track, and you will see now we start adding them, they'll automatically be looking for our active buses. So the first master fader track here will be a master fader for the verb send. So if we play this, I can... So this becomes my master for the verb bus. And if we add another fader track, it'll just go further in the sequence of my bundles that I set up. So now this will go to ambience. So this will control our ambience. One thing that's cool about doing a master fader track for your synths is, of course, if you have multiple synths going to one effect, that you can control all of them at once using the master fader track. Of course, you can always group your synths in the channels and do it that way too. So there's so many ways you can control your workflow and your faders, your volumes like that. But this is just a short intro to how the routing works. And while we look at the inserts here on the channel strips, all the inserts we see here, they are right now pre-fader. But if you for some reason would like to run something post-fader, you see this little dot here on all the channels? You can actually grab this dot, you see moving the cursor over it. Then you can grab this dot, becomes a line, and you can move it upwards and select everything that is below the line is now post-fader. Another little thing we should explore before ending this, go back to the mini menu. You see you can add EQ graph to the mixing window, EQ control, you see it starts showing up here, dynamics graph, and dynamics control. So what does this do? This will actually show us if we add, let's take the MW FET 76, and now you'll see that becomes part of our window. We can actually interact with the plugin right here in the channel strip. That's our dynamics. Let's move dynamics down to 2 and insert an equalizer. And now you'll see the equalizer here. So we can interface here with the MW EQ. When we start changing something here, you will actually see it working in the channel strip. So let's add a high pass filter here, and you can actually see it right over here how it works. I forgot to mention here regarding the number of synths on the channels that you can set the number of synths right from the mini menu. So we can type in like 10, and you will see now we have 10 synths here in the mixer. Let's change the number again, set number of effect synths to 3 this time. One thing that I want you to be aware of, again, let's go back in the mini menu and see I have selected where it says automatically add inserts. What this does is, in this case where I have 3 inserts, if I add one insert here in the empty, the lowest empty spot, let's just you'll see it automatically added another row of inserts. So if we add something here, you see it added another insert point. And that comes from having this set. So you don't really have to preset how many effect inserts you want to have in your project before you start working. Just have this automatically add inserts. Next thing you can do in the mini menu is also you can save the layout of your board. So say I want to use this layout a lot, which I do, then I'll simply save this as my board and call it full. Then I might have situations where I want to have the mixer and maybe the sequence editor on top. So in that case, I might want to take out all this. That's very nice to look at, very nice to work with. But I just want to have maybe basically the faders and nothing but the faders here. So we can even take controls out. So there we go. And then we will save this layout. And I'll call this minimal. So now we can go back to load board layout and we can go to full. And then I can easily go back to the minimal.